Hey everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video I want to show you the best travel accessories that I use on a regular basis. I use them pretty much for every flight, and after maybe 30 to 50 flights I found for me the best setup and all the necessary items that I usually take with me to survive long distance economy class flights and also calm down a little bit in the plane, because sometimes I'm also quite a nervous flyer, and before I changed my job I was even a little bit scared of flying. So relax and enjoy the video. So first of all, often I take an empty water bottle with me, because I can use it to put some vitamin pills inside when I receive the water at the plane, and can mix some juice or whatever I can do with it. Then I have my laptop of course with me, I have a book with me to make some notes, and all of these things of course are not necessary items. So the first thing that I would advise you is to take a good book with you that you would like to read, as you probably have a lot of time, especially on a long distance flight. So you can use the time efficiently and just read the book that you maybe already planned to read, but when you or for what you never found the time. Then the next thing I would advise you to take with you are definitely charger cables for your mobile or for your tablet or whatever. And often in the planes you at least have one USB connector. In some of the bigger planes like the A380 you even have two USB connectors, so if you have two mobiles or one tablet, one mobile, you can charge both at the same time. Then the next thing I would advise you to take with you is 100% a neck pillow, because as you know, in economy class on a long distance flight, and maybe you hit the worst case, so you sit in the middle between two other persons, then it's usually very uncomfortable, and as I said, especially over a long time. So the best you can make out of this situation is take a neck pillow with you. Then at least with the neck pillow you can try to find some sleep or to rest your head in between those other two persons. And I would also advise you to get a neck pillow with a pump that you can inflate with air, so if you're not using it, it will not take a lot of space in your duffel bag. And yeah, the duffel bag is also one of the items that I find is super convenient for your travels. If you're going to the security control, you need to get out your laptop. It's way more convenient to get it out of a duffel bag than instead getting your suitcase, your carry-on suitcase, opening the suitcase, getting out the laptop, closing the suitcase again, and after the security control putting all the stuff inside. I think with the duffel bag you're 10 times faster, and especially in the plane you could even put the duffel bag below your seat. Let's assume the worst case again, if you would sit in the middle between two people, and you can access all the stuff that you have in your duffel bag. So way better than having a carry-on suitcase for me. And that's why I usually nowadays travel with a check-in suitcase, so I have enough space for all my belongings, and for the cabin I only take the duffel bag. Then I have a few pens and pencils in my duffel bag, but this is of course not a necessary item, it's just here in the duffel bag. Then the next accessory I take with me on really every flight, and I cannot advise it enough for you, is a pair of noise cancellation headphones. I bought these Bose headphones, I don't know, maybe a year ago or so, and I really use them on every flight, and it's the best thing in the world when you turn them on and you don't hear the loud noise that the engines produce in the airplane. And also if the captain is changing something, maybe is changing something with the wheels or so, which would make a scary sound for some people. You will not hear it with these noise cancellation headphones, so they really calm you down if you are normally a nervous flyer. In addition, you have this connector cable that you can also use it with other devices if you don't want to use it via Bluetooth. And in addition, it's important that you buy the right connector. So for example, on Emirates, you need this 2-pins connector that you can also enjoy your entertainment during the flight. So yeah, don't forget to buy this. The Bose headphones come in this nice leather pocket, and I often use this pocket during the flight if I have the headphones on my head to store all my small things inside, like the phones, the wallet, key, whatever, everything I don't want to keep in my trousers for convenience. So I just put it in the Bose pocket and then store that in the seat pocket in the airplane. So you see, these were most of the accessories that I have in my duffel bag. And the last thing I would advise you, even if I'm a big fan of classic watches for flying, I just love my Apple Watch. And why do I love it? So this watch has a functionality that it reminds you every hour to stand up at least for a minute. And imagine you're on a long distance flight, as I fly quite often from Dubai to South Africa, and that's I think around 8 or 9 hours. This watch will remind me 8 to 9 times to stand up, and when it reminds me, I usually use this to walk to the toilet or just stand up, walk a little bit around, that I'm refreshing my legs and my legs don't feel super tired when I arrive at the destination. Yeah, so these were my favorite travel accessories, and as I said before, I changed my job position. I only did a very few flights per year, so I was usually a very nervous flyer. And especially the headphones helped me to really relax during a flight, and all of these other accessories I usually use now during the flights. I found out by experience, by doing so many flights now per year, that this is for me the perfect setup. So as I'm packing now everything back into my duffel bag, I want to say goodbye and thank you for watching this video. I would be super happy if you subscribe to my channel, and then hopefully see you in the next video. So have a good day and bye bye.